Story time. So, my name is Raymond Yusuf from the Critics Company, and today I'm going to tell you what it's like to give a TED Talk. So on the 31st of January 2019, I received a mail inviting me to come speak at the TEDx event at the Bayero University Kano, and Kano is just 3 hours from Kaduna. So, well, it was mad. So at about February, I received a message from them, and I was asked to actually come up with a topic for my TED Talk and send my bio and my picture. So at that certain point, we were quite occupied with a project we were working on, so I was busy. But anyways, it was the first step, which was actually coming up with the topic, was quite hard, because the theme of the event was Think It, Fix It. Yeah, it was like a relatable topic that we were quite used to, because while shooting our short films, we had to actually embrace that mentality constantly. So, but now coming up with the actual topic to speak about on that event was like a very complex situation, and I and Ridwan came up with like 5 different topics until I finally decided to go with the art of visual magic. Then few weeks before the event, I was asked to actually write like my speech, and at that point I was quite busy. The entire team was busy, we were working on a particular project, and also we were planning on shooting a new short film and stuff like that. So we started, so it took me about 5 days to come up with a speech, because I was procrastinating a lot. I would just start, pause, and keep writing. So when I finally came up with the speech, during those days I was like practicing with like the boys in the team, and I was just trying to get over the, because I'm a shy person, so I was trying to like be bold and be able to like face the crowd. So I was just practicing, and during that point I started losing vibes for the event. Like, I did not want to go anymore. And also, the week where the event was supposed to happen, we were actually working on our short film Into the Woods, so I was already thinking of like quitting. But I was able to like finally like just decide, and I decided to actually go for the event.
I'm sort of hyped up, I guess, for the event.
So I got the speech ready, and at about that time the coronavirus issue was like beginning to get rampant and stuff. So it was almost, the event was almost pushed back. Even the schools were actually on strike, so there was a possibility that the event would have been pushed back. But still, it was able to happen, and it was actually quite cool. So on the 13th of March 2020, we left Kaduna to Kano, and we got there and we lodged in the hotel, and I was still practicing. We walked around Kano, and Kano is actually a beautiful place, like it's just awesome. So, and the next day came, I was nervous. I think it took me a while to sleep in the night. And when we got to the school, we got to the event center, because the event center is actually in the school. And yeah, I watched a lot of grown-up people talk, deliver their speeches well, and my speech happened like later on in the event. So I was still practicing a few minutes before my speech, and my name was called, and I went on stage, and the blinding lights hit me, like I almost lost my balance. But I started to actually ease in to the speech, and it was going well, and I finally ended, and whew, a sigh of relief came out of me. And after that speech, I was actually grateful to God for allowing me come, and grateful to myself for actually deciding to not forfeit the event. I had a wonderful time and a wonderful feeling after delivering the speech. The most challenging part of preparing for the TED Talk was actually coming up with the speech. So I had started working on some VFX shots, and also we were working on VFX shots for a particular client commercial project. So, and I don't really give a lot of speeches. I'm not a motivational speaker. So coming up with a speech was hard. So I don't think the TEDx event is quite different from other events. You're just saying speeches like other events, but I feel it's quite inspiring because it's a TED event. So anyways, all you just have to do is just be bold and courageous and step on that stage and own it. I'm not actually sure if the talk is going to inspire somebody, but it might inspire somebody. Maybe not now, maybe now, or probably in the future. But the reason I chose that topic was just to actually explain how beautiful the art of visual magic can be and the possibilities that we can do. And also it was majorly directed to other young teenagers in Africa and in the world like me, who want to actually just do stuff, and they shouldn't hold back. They should let their imaginations out and try to bring them to life, and with the help of visual magic they can actually do it. So who knows. Here are my three tips for anyone who wants to give a TED talk. This is personal advice from me to you. So number one, prepare well and seek advice from professionals or someone who has like an experience with giving speeches. Then number two, be passionate about whatever you're going to speak about. Since it's what you love, since it's what you do, speak about it and you'll be able to flow well and you won't be nervous on stage. And number three, just go do it. Don't think about it too much. Just go and do it. And also, I want to say a big thank you to Sherifat, Yunusa and her team of extraordinary young minds. And it's just actually inspiring seeing a group of young people come together to actually make a difference in their community. So a big shout out to you all. At last, we got things done. We got it done and it happened. So y'all could go watch the TEDx video. There's going to be a link in the description below. And also tell me what you think about it. Love to hear your comments and all. Peace out.